huge civilizational history behind it. But some ill-informed people will make us believe that Kashmir was never part of Bharat. Don't learn history from such people.
Kashmir has never been an integral part of India.
Ghulam Nabi Azad has repeatedly said this. Now that the Supreme Court has hit the final nail on 370, let's not forget 370 was also just 70 years old. And now we are set to rise for Naya Jammu Kashmir. This is a good time to see how Kashmir has always been a part of Vedic Sanatan culture. Ye Rishi Kashyap ki land hai. If I start naming the Sanatan Dharma scholars from coming from Kashmir, this video will run into hours. But still, I will try and make a little attempt. Acharya Charak, he wrote the Charak Samhita, which is taught in Ayurveda colleges even today. And this is 400 before Christ. Lagadha, mathematics and astronomy expert, wrote the Vedang Jyotisha, which is used even today. And 700 BC, Pandit Vishnu Sharma, Panchatantra. 300 BC, Nagasena, Sanskrit expert and Buddhist scholar. Bharat Muni, treatise on performing arts with 600 shlokas. Matlab, ye history is so many hundreds and thousands of years before Christ that historians don't even have the correct timeline. Vasugupta wrote the Shiva Sutras and Spandakarikas. Modern scientists aaj bhi na samaj paaye such mood concepts of self-realization and consciousness. Abhinav Gupta, spiritual master who wrote 35 works on Kashmir Shaivism, on the Advaita tradition, which heavily influenced Sri Vidya in the southern part of India. His magnum opus, Tantra Lok, agar aap aaj bhi Amazon se order kare, it runs into volumes. Aap convince ho gaye ki main aur bolu. The list is endless. Kshemaraja, philosopher who wrote about different levels of consciousness. Somananda, descendant of Rishi Durvasa, wrote the Shiva Drishti. Utpaladeva, Shaivism scholar. Anandavardhana wrote the Dhvanya Loka, giving the theory of Dhvani or sound and how it impacts emotion. Matlab, mind-boggling work on consciousness, philosophy is happening here, which is not finding any mention in modern philosophical studies. Hum apni list continue karte hain, video dekhte rahiye. Bhamaha, Kavya Alankar, which means ornaments of poetry in Sanskrit. Vagbhat, he wrote the Ashtang Hriday, which is read by Ayurveda doctors even today. Vopodeva, Kashmir grammarian who wrote the Mughobatesha. Jayant Bhatt, Kashmiri poet, grammarian and philosopher of the Nyaya school of Hindu philosophy. His book Nyaya Manjari is referred to even today when we talk of existence of God. Let's come to Kalidas, who was almost 1,000 years before Shakespeare, but hamara colonial mindset calls him the Shakespeare of the East. He was not born in Kashmir, but he wrote there extensively. Then coming to Patanjali, almost 140 years before Christ, but the date is not certain because nobody has taken the time to date these texts. Yoga Vashishtha was written in Kashmir almost 100 BC with 29,000 verses on consciousness, time, space, cognition, stuff that modern science is struggling with even today. My list is not complete yet, but you get the idea. Don't be fooled by anyone who says ki Kashmir hamara nahi hai ya Kashmir was never part of Bharat. Learn your history properly.